Pascal's law can also be explained by using the example hydrostatic paradox. Using an example hydrostatic paradox, we explain the Pascal's law. This hydrostatic paradox contains different containers of different shape. All these containers are connected with a horizontal pipe. Now it is having four containers A, B, C and D. In hydrostatic paradox, there are four containers A, B and C, D of different shapes. Now if we pour some liquid in one container, then the liquid starts rising in all containers to equal heights. Means liquid level will be at same height in all containers. How does this explains the Pascal's law? Let us see here. In this horizontal tube, let us consider four points here. Now, all these four points are at a same horizontal level. If they are at same horizontal level, there should be same pressure. Suppose on the every container is open to the atmosphere, so that on the top surface of an every container there is atmospheric pressure PA will act. And suppose at these points in different container pressures are PA, PB, PC and PD. If you take a container A first, now we know the equation P2 minus P1 is equals to rho GH. At a depth h, the pressure is given by P2 is equal P1 plus rho GH, or difference P2 minus P1 is equal to rho GH. Now P2 is nothing but PA here, minus P1 means P small a is equal to rho GH. Now I can write PA is equal to P small a plus rho GH. Now here this height is the same for all, so that the pressure is same at all points. Now if we pour the liquid, all are rising in all containers, liquid is rising to the same height, so that height h is for us all, height is same for all, so that this PA plus rho GH is same for all. If we find a pressure at a point B, that is PB, PB also PA plus rho GH. At point C, pressure also PC is equal to PA plus rho GH. And at point D also, PD is equal to PA plus rho GH. Means the points P, points all are at a same horizontal level, so that at all points pressure is same, that is given by PA plus rho GH, so that the liquid rises to the same height in all containers. So in this way, using hydrostatic paradox, we explain the Pascal's law.